बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल ताइफ वर्चुअल लर्निंग सिस्टम। टुडे इज आवर 10th वीडियो लेक्चर। वी ऑलरेडी डन टू एक्सरसाइजेज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2, एक्सरसाइज 2.1 एंड 2.2 इन रैशनल नंबर्स। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू एक्सरसाइज, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 2.3। In exercise 2.3, first question is related with the rational numbers, that which one rational pair of rational numbers are given, and you have to identify that these rational number in these rational numbers, which one is greater, which one is less, or which one are equal. So how can you find it? You have given different rational numbers. You have to make the denominator same, and after that you can easily identify that which one rational number is greater and which one is less, or which one are equal. In this question number 1, you have total 12 parts. Some parts I will discuss with you in this video lecture, and some part you will do it as your homework. In question number 1, first part, you have given 1 over 2 and 15 over 20. Both are given in form of fraction. So you can't easily identify without making the denominator same, that which one rational number is greater and which one is smaller. So what will you do? The first step is that you make the denominator same. This is 20, so you can easily make this 220. How? By multiplying 10 with the numerator and the same number you multiply with the denominator. Remember one thing, when you make the fraction same and you multiply from your own side any number with the denominator, the same number you multiply with the numerator. So 10, why with 10? Because 2 tens are 20. So the 10 you multiplying from your own side, so the same number you multiply in the numerator, 10. So 1 tens are 10 and 2 tens are 20. So it will be 10 over 20 and 15 over 20 you write as it is. Now look at these two rational numbers. The denominators are same, 20 and 20. So look at the numerator. Numerator will tell you that which one number is greater. So 10 and 15. So 15 is greater than 10. So this symbol will open to 15. Remember one thing, how you can identify, how you can put these symbols, it will always open to the greater number. Consider this is the crocodile mouth and it will open to the more food. So which one number is greater, it will open to that number. So 15 is greater than 10 because the denominators are same. So we just check the numerator, 15 is greater than 10. So it will be open to like this, means that 15 over 20 is greater than this. Now you will write the original number. 10 over 20 come from which one number? 1 over 2. So you write, which implies that 1 over 2 is less than 15 over 20, or you can read it like this, 15 over 20 is greater than 1 over 2. So its mouth will always open to the greater number. So this is the first part. Again, I'm going to repeat it. Here you have given in the denominator 2 and here you have given 20. When you have given fraction to identify that which one rational number is greater and which one is smaller, so you make their denominator same. So 22, you can easily make 20. How? By multiplying 10. 2 tens are 20. So the same number you multiply with the numerator. 1 tens are 10, 10 over 20 and 15 over 20. So which one number is greater? 15 is greater. So the sign will open to 15. So 15 over 20. After that, which implies that this symbol is, which implies that 1 over 2, the original number you will write, 1 over 2 is less than 15 over 20, or you can say that 15 over 20 is greater than 1 over 2. Now come to the next part. Part number 2. Here you can, without simplification, you can easily identify that which one number is greater, but you will do it step by step. Look, this is minus 2 over 3 and this is 1 over 6. So it means that minus 2 over 3 and 1 over 6. So the negative number is always less than the positive number. So means that 1 over 6 is greater than minus 2 over 3. But we do it step by step. How can we do it? We make the denominator same. 3, we can easily make 6 by multiplying with 2. So when we multiply 3 with 2, 3 2s are 6, the same 2 multiply with the numerator. So 3 with 2 and 2 with 2. So we get minus 4 over 6 and this is 1 over 6. So which one number is greater? 1 over 6 is greater than minus 4 over 6. So which implies that 1 over 6 is greater than minus 4 over 6. And we write the original number minus 4 over 6 come from minus 2 over 3. So in place of minus 4 over 6, we write the original number, which is less than 1 over 6. So you can say that 1 over 6 is greater than minus 2 over 3. Again, if it will come in MCQs and you have given that which one sign will come less than, greater than, or equal or none. So how can you identify if it is negative number and the other number is positive? So it's understood that the positive number is always greater than the negative number. So direct you put this sign, it will open to 1 over 6. But if it will come in short question, then you do it step by step like this. The denominator you will make same, 3 multiply with 2 and then minus 2 multiply with 2. And then when you simplify it, so 2 2s are 4, minus sign as it is, 3 2s are 6 and this 1 over 6 as it is. So 1 over 6 and minus 4 over 6 you get. So 1 is positive, 1 is greater than minus 4. So when you identify that which one number is greater, so minus 4 over 6 come from minus 2 over 3. So which implies that minus 2 over 3 is less than 1 over 6. Or you can read it like this, 1 over 6 is greater than minus 2 over 3. Come to the next part. In next part, you have given minus 1 over 5 and 2 over minus 10. Again, minus 1 over 5 or minus 2 over 10. It doesn't matter if the negative sign is given in numerator or denominator. If it is given in numerator, minus divided by plus, again, it will equal to minus, and plus divided by minus, again, it will equal to minus. So it means that both fractions, both rational numbers are negative. So this 5, we can easily make it 10 by making the denominator same. So 5 halves are 10, 5 twos are 10. So 5 twos are 10, and the same which number you multiply with the denominator from your own side, to make the denominator same, the same number you multiply with the numerator. So minus 1 multiply 2, 5 multiply 2, and this number you write it as it is. In second step, minus 2 ones are 2 and 5 twos are 10. If you check it, minus 2 over 10 and minus 2 over 10, both are same, both are equal. Both look at the numerator, 2, 2. The denominator, 10 and 10. One is negative, other one is also negative. It doesn't matter if the negative sign is in the numerator, and in the other rational numbers, the negative sign is in the denominator. Because minus, if in the numerator and in the denominator plus, so minus divided by plus, it is equal to minus. And plus in the numerator and minus in the denominator, so plus divided by minus, again it is equal to minus. So minus 2 over 10 is equal to minus 2 over 10. So which one sign will come in between both rational numbers? Equal sign. So minus 2 over 10, this comes from the value minus 1 over 5, which implies that minus 1 over 5 is equal to 2 over minus 10. So both fractions are equal when you make the denominator same. Now come to the fourth part, minus 1 over 9 and minus 4 over 3. Now negative sign with both numbers. So what will you do? You make the denominator same. So which one denominator you can easily make equal by multiplying which number? Look, 9 we can make this 3 is 9. How? By multiplying with 3. 3 halves are 9. 3 threes are 9. So with this, the first fraction, the first value we write as it is. The second value we multiply the numerator and the denominator with 3 to make the denominator same. So minus 1 over 9, comma, minus 4 multiply with 3 and 3 multiply with 3. The number which you multiply from your own side to make the denominator same, the same number you multiply with the numerator. So minus 1 over 9 we copy as it is, minus sign as it is, 4 threes are 12 and 9. Now look, both the denominator values are 9. So we will identify that which one number is greater. If you think about the number line, minus 1 is near to the positive number as compared to minus 12. So which one is greater? Minus 1 is greater than minus 12. Remember one thing, with negative sign, if you compare two numbers, so the greater number value will be less if it having negative sign, and the smaller value if it having negative sign will be more. How? Because if you think about the number line, in number line you know that the negative one is near to positive 1 or 0 and minus 12 is far. So means that the number which is near to 0, that the negative number which is near to 0, that will be more as compared to minus 12. So minus 1 over 9 is greater than minus 12 over 9. So minus 1 over 9 you will write it as it is, and minus 12 over 9 come from which number? From minus 4 over 3. So which implies that minus 1 over 9 is greater than minus 4 over 3. Come to the next part, fifth part. In fifth part you have given minus 1 and the second one is minus 2 over 3. One is given a simple number and the other one is given in form of fraction. You know that if in the denominator there is nothing, so one should be present. So you can write it minus 1 over 1. You know, if there is nothing in the denominator, so means that one is present. It's understood. If nothing in the denominator, so one is present. So here to make the denominators same, what will we do? 1 over 1 first we write 1 over 1 and then multiply with 3. How? Because it is 3 and here in the denominator if nothing, so 1. So 1 halves are 3, 1 threes are 3. So multiply and divide by 3, the numerator with 3 and the denominator with 3. So minus sign and 3 ones are 3 and 3 ones are 3. Now look at the denominators are same, both are negative, both rational numbers are negative. So which one is greater? If you think about the number line we already draw numbers, rational numbers on a number line in exercise 2.1. If you think about the number line, so minus 2 is near to the positive numbers, to 0 and 1, as compared to minus 3. So means that minus 2, remember, if two numbers both having negative sign, so the greater number is considered smaller and the smaller number is considered greater. It having its weightage is more than the greater number. So minus 2 is greater than minus 3. Minus 2 is greater than minus 3. So minus 3 over 3, which implies that it comes from minus 1. We write the original number, the sign as it is, and minus 2 over 3. So this is the fifth part. 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th and 11th. You will do it by yourself. It's very easy. Just you make the denominator same first. The number which you multiply with the denominator to make the denominator same. The same number you multiply with the numerator. And try to do it and then send it on WhatsApp when you do your homework. So please try to send only the homework question. The question which I discuss in a video lecture, no need to send those questions. You just copy it in your notebook. And the remaining parts which you do it by yourself, give the homework heading. And after that, you solve those questions which is not in the video lecture and then send it on WhatsApp. Now come to the 12th part. In 12th part, you have given minus 8 over 11 and minus 3 over 10. If you check, 11 is a prime number. So we can't make 11 is 10 or 10 is 11. Now in such case, in which you can't easily make the denominator same by simply multiplying with any number. So what will you do? This denominator 10, you multiply with the first rational number, and this 11 you multiply in the numerator and the denominator with the second fraction. Because this 11 is a prime number and we can't make it 10, and this 10 we can't make it 11. So what will we do? Then we do it like this, that the first fraction we multiply with the numerator and the denominator with 10, and the second fraction we multiply the denominator and the numerator with 11. This, when you having such type of denominators in both numbers which you can't make it same by multiplying with any number, then you do it like this. Or you take the LCM. In both way you can do. You can take the LCM of 11 and minus 11 and 10, you will get the LCM 110. So you multiply 11 with that number which gave you 110, and the same 10 you multiply with that number which gave you 110. So in both cases, you can solve it by taking LCM or by simply multiplying and divide the numerator and the denominator with the other fraction denominator value. And the second fraction you multiply and divide with the first fraction denominator value. So it will be minus 80, 11 tens are 110, and plus divided by minus, minus 3 elevens are 33 and 10 elevens are 110. Again, look. The denominators, both denominators are same. The numerators, from the numerators, we can identify that which one number is greater and which one is smaller. In previous question, in question number 5, I already discussed with you, if the number is small, if you have two numbers, both having minus sign like this. So the number which is smaller, it having more weightage, or it will be considered greater. And the number which is greater, it will be considered smaller, because the minus sign, if you think about number line, so it will more near to the positive number. So minus 33 is greater than minus 1, minus 80. Minus 33 over 1 over 10 is greater than minus 81 over 10. Now this number, which implies that this number come from minus 8 over 11. So minus 8 over 11 less than 3 over minus 10, the original number, you write it at the end in answer. So this is question number 1. In question number 1, what we study? You have given two rational numbers and you have to identify that which one rational number is greater and which one is smaller, or which two fractions or pair of fractions are equal. So for this, we do first of all, we make the denominator same. How can we make the denominator same? If it is possible by multiplying with any multiple to make the denominator same, you will do it like that. Otherwise, you take the LCM and make the denominator same. Or you can do it like this, which we done in 12th part. So the remaining parts, you try it by yourself and send it on WhatsApp. Now come to the next question, question number 2. Question number 2 is, arrange the following numbers in descending order. So Dear students, you already know that what is descending order. You already studied it in class 5, in class 6, and also in junior classes. So descending means from greater to smaller. But if you have given rational numbers, so how can you identify that which one number is the biggest and which one is after that and which one is the smaller one? So what will you do? You make the denominator same, then you can easily identify that which one number is the greatest and which one is smaller, and after that which one is the smallest. Descending order from greater to smaller. Remember, descending order from greater to smaller. If you have three numbers like 7, 8, 9. So if you arrange it in descending order, so that will be 9, 8, 7 from greater to smaller. Now come to the first part. In first part, you have given 1 over 2, 2 over 3 and 8 over 9. So if you check, the 9 is the greatest number in the denominator, but you can't say that which one number is greatest and which one is on the second position and which one is in the third position. First of all, you make the denominator same. How can you make the denominator same? Look, from 3, we can easily make 9 by multiplying 3. But from 2, we can't make 9. So in such cases, which you can't solve it by direct multiple, by multiplying with any number to make the denominator same, what will you do? You take LCM like this, which I told you in 12th part, that if the denominators are different, so what will you do? You take the LCM of the denominator in rough work. This is rough work. So what will you do? As the LCM of 2, 3 and 9 is. So how can you take 2, 3 and 9? So the smallest prime number 2, 2 ones are 2. And 3 is not divisible by 2. So we write 3 as it is. 9 not divisible, we write as it is. Then divide it by 3. 1 we write as it is. 3 ones are 3. And 3 threes are 9. Then again divide by 3. 1 as it is. 1 as it is. 3 ones are 3. So LCM, how can you take? By multiplying these numbers. 2 threes are 6. 6 threes are 18. So LCM is 18. Now what will you do when you take the LCM? You will make all the denominator 18. So 2 multiply by which number to get 18? Yes, 9. So 2 nines are 18. So the same 9 we multiply in the numerator. 3 halves are 18. 3 sixths are 18. So we multiply the numerator and the denominator with 6. And 9 twos are 18. So 2 multiply. Look, LCM is 18. What will we do? First, we write all the denominator and then we take the LCM of the denominator. So 2 threes are 6. 6 threes are 18. LCM is 18. So what will we do after that? We multiply the 2 with that number which gave us 18. 2 9s are 18, so 9 with the numerator. 3 6s are 18, so 6 with the numerator also. And 9 2s are 18, so 2 also with the numerator. So what will we get? 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 8 2s are 16, 9 2s are 18. Now all the denominators same. Now we can easily identify that which one is the greatest number, which one is on the second position and which one is the smallest. So if you check 9, 12 and 16, which one number is the greatest? 16, descending order from greater to smaller. So 16 over 18 we will write first, and after that the greater number 12, 12 over 18, and after that 9 over 18. Like this we arrange in descending order. Now 16 over 18 we get from which number? From 8 over 9. So here we write the original number, 16 over, in place of 16 over 18, the original number from which we get 16 over 18, 8 over 9. And 12 over 18 we get from 2 over 3. So the second position is 2 over 3. And for the third position or the last one is we get from 1 over 2. So we write it 1 over 2 like this. We arrange the rational numbers in descending order. Again, I'm going to repeat it. We have three rational numbers. First, we take the LCM of these three rational numbers, the denominator value LCM. 2, 3, and 9 are the denominator. So we take the LCM of this. We get 18 is the LCM. After that, we multiply 2 and 2 with that number, which gave us 18. That is 9. So the same 9 we multiply with the numerator also. And 3, how's the 18 we get? 6, so 6 we multiply with the numerator and with the denominator. And 9 2's are 18, so the same number we multiply with the numerator and the denominator. We get these numbers. So when we get these fractions, so in this you can check the denominator's value are same, the numerators are different, so we can easily arrange them in descending order. The greatest value is 16, after that 12, after that 9. 16 over 18 we get from 8 over 9, so we write the original number 8 over 9, and then 2 over 3, 12 over 18 we get from 2 over 3, and 9 over 18 we get from 1 over 2. So we write it in descending order like this. Now come to the second part of the same question, that is 1 over 6, 3 over 4, and 1 over 2. So here we can easily make 2 is 4, but we can't make 4 is 6. So what will we do? The same step which we done in the previous question, the denominator's value 6, 4, and 2, we take the LCM of these numbers 6, 4, and 2. We take the LCM. So we write the number as it is, LCM of 6, 4, and 2. So with the smallest prime numbers, you know that when we take LCM, we start from the, if it is divisible by the smallest prime number, so we start from 2. So 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. Again, it's divisible by 2. 3 is not divisible, so we write 3 as it is, but 2 is divisible. 3 we write as it is, 2 1s are 2, 1 we write as it is. Now again with 3, 3 1s are 3, 1 we write as it is, 1 we write as it is. So LCM is what? Multiplying these numbers, this will give you LCM. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. So LCM is 12. Now this 1 over 6, we make the denominator value is 12. So we will check that which one number we multiply with 6 to get 12. 6 how's a 12? Yes, 6 2's a 12. So 6 2's a 12, the numerator 1 and 6, both we multiply with 2. Because this is rule, when you multiply any number with the numerator, the same number you multiply with the denominator. Now 4 how's a 12? 4 3's a 12. So the numerator and the denominator multiply with 3. 2 how's a 12? 2 6's a 12. So the numerator and the denominator multiply with 6. Look at this. 6 2's a 12 and multiply with the numerator. 4 3's a 12, multiply with the numerator. The LCM which we get, 12, that we make in the denominator. So 2 how's a 12? 2 6 are 12, multiply with the numerator. So what we get? 2 over 12, 3 3's are 9, 9 over 12, 6 1's are 6, 6 over 12. Now from this, the denominators are same. From the numerator, you can easily identify that which one number is greater and which one is smaller. So the greatest number in this is 9. So means that when you arrange in descending order, so 9 over 12, then 6 over 12, then 2 over 12, like this. 9 over 12, 6 over 12, and 2 over 12. Now you will check that 9 over 12 come from which fraction? From 3 over 4. So you write the number 3 over 4 first. And then 6 over 12 come from which number? 6 over 12 come from 1 over 2. So you write that number 1 over 2. And then 2 over 12 come from which number? From 1 over 6. You write it 1 over 6. So this is the descending order. In this question number 2, you have total 3 parts. 2 parts I discuss with you. I hope you will understand it. The third one part you do it is a homework. So here you have home assignment. Question number 1, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th and 11th part, and question number 2, 3 part. So this is your homework. Try to do it. It's very easy. And if you remember the rule that how to make the numbers same, then you can easily solve it. The denominators make same by multiplying with the number or by taking LCM. LCM method we done in question number 2, and question number 1 we simply multiply to make the denominator same. Multiply with the multiple to make the denominator same. So best of luck. Allah Hafiz.